Bishop Ford was a missionary, and he was, devoted to his people.
A missionary who's been called a martyr and who many would like to call a saint. A documentary about the life of Brooklyn-born Bishop Francis Xavier Ford is airing tonight, right after this newscast here on Net TV, on what would have been his 129th birthday. It's part of the Bishop Ford Guild's mission to promote his cause for sainthood. And Ed Wilkinson, former editor at The Tablet, helped create the documentary. He's here now. And so, Ed, tell us, why did you make this documentary?
Well, Christine, the Bishop Ford Guild reached out to us, and they asked us if we could make a film to promote this cause and also to help them raise some money to promote the cause, because it's a very costly thing to get somebody beatified these days.
Sure.
It's a long process.
Absolutely.
And so Terry Dennellen, who is one of our producers over there, and I, we went up to Mary Knoll, and we did a lot of research up there, and Terry really was the guy who put the nuts and bolts together. I did a lot of the research, and I did the interviews with him, and it was just the two of us. It took us about a year to get it done. And
wow.
Originally, the Guild was going to take this out to parishes and to show it, you know, to help make their cause a little bit better known.
But instead, because of the pandemic, you're now having it airing on
because
the...
Because of the pandemic, nobody could go out and speak in parishes.
Right.
You know, they were practically closed down. So we had this thing sitting on the shelf, and I said to somebody, I know we're going to do a lot of publicity about Bishop Ford around his birthday. Why don't we just show this documentary on TV? And they said, of course, you know, it's sitting here. Let's use it. And
great idea.
It's a beautiful piece of work. Mm-hmm. It really is.
Now tell us, why do you think his path to sainthood is taking so long?
Well, actually, I don't think it's taken so long myself. It's,
okay.
I think it's pretty quick. You know, in the past, it would take sometimes hundreds of years to get somebody canonized.
Okay.
But Bishop Ford, you know, today with a lot more media, these people are better known. And when somebody is martyred like that over in China, the word gets out and a devotion begins to follow him.
Right.
And so I think we're going to see it, hopefully, in my lifetime.
All right, I hope so. And it's a beautiful documentary. Let's take a quick look at a clip from the documentary.
When it happened, he was arrested, bound, marched through the streets. He and a marital sister, convicted in a trial that we don't have any record of.
Hmm. So what surprised you the most while making this documentary?
I think what surprised me the most was reading about the forced march that he was put on to get to the prison camp. It was like 50 miles. He was marched through the streets and really humiliated. And then the harsh conditions in the camp. One of the nuns who was arrested with him and put in the prison camp, she recalls seeing Bishop Ford in the camp thrown over the shoulder of somebody else like a sack of potatoes. His health had failed so badly there. And so eventually he just died of natural causes in the communist prison camp.
Right. So why should people watch this documentary?
Well, I think they should watch it because he's one of us. He's a Brooklyn boy.
Right.
He came from right these streets that we came from, and he was a man with a great vision and a real dedication and commitment to the missions. He was a real, genuine person. If Bishop Ford's not a saint, I don't know who is a saint.
Hmm. So how can people donate to the Guild?
You can help the Guild out by go to thetablet.org.
Mm-hmm.
That's the site, thetablet.org. There's a wonderful article on there this week about the Bishop Ford Guild. And at the end of it, there's an enrollment form. So if somebody wants to get involved, better involved with the Guild, they just fill that out and they can participate in this course.
Well, I think everybody should take a look at it, and I definitely will. Ed Wilkinson, thanks so much for being here.
Thank you, Christine.
If you're watching Currents News on YouTube, be sure to hit the subscribe button and click on the bell to get updates to all of our newest content, because we are putting your faith in the news.